What's happening, ladies and gentlemen? This is Min from Architecture Inspirations. Today, I'm gonna show you the first part of my post-production process in Photoshop, which is adding the background to your rendering. Let's get started. Number 1, adding the sky. First, make sure you save your renderings as PNG after you render. This will give you a transparent background to your image and make it easier to add the sky and surrounding buildings in Photoshop. Now, right-click the base image and open it in Photoshop. After, choose a sky that you would like to use as your background, then drag and drop it into Photoshop or use this option here to import it. I'll leave some links in the description box below to help you choose a perfect sky for your image and also some free resources where you can get free sky images. Once it's imported, you need to place your sky below your base image. You can then transform it to make it best fit your rendering. Just select the layer and press Ctrl T to activate free transform mode and transform it to whatever looks best. Number 2, adding the surrounding buildings. Like I mentioned in the last video of this series, you should consider adding buildings in Photoshop if you have empty spaces in your renderings like I do in this one. Sometimes you can't find a single perfect picture to fill in that space. If so, then you can composite multiple images to make that perfect picture you're looking for. First, you have to find the images with the correct perspective. For example, this tree in my rendering is curving in this direction, so I have an idea of the perspective of my buildings. Now I just have to find pictures of buildings with that similar perspective. Once you've found those images, you can start compositing them. A good way to do it is by using layer mask. If you are not familiar with layer mask, it is a non-destructive way to control the transparency of your image. What this means is that you can hide parts of the image that you don't want without truly deleting it, so you can recurve it anytime you like. So how do you do it? First, select the layer that you want to use, then make a selection of the part that you want to make visible. You can do this by either using the marquee tool, the lasso tool, or the pen tool. Now click on this button on your layer window to add a layer mask. When you do this, the selected area will remain and the unselected area will be masked and reveals the layer below it. If you want to edit the mask, you can paint the mask white to reveal more of the image or paint it black to hide more of it. This gives you a lot of control over your image and gives you the option to edit it whenever you want. On the other hand, if you were to delete part of the image, it's difficult to recover it without hitting the undo button again and again. So that's one of the buildings. Now I just repeat this part for the other buildings and put them together like so. Compositing images can be difficult at first, but I'm confident you will get better at it. So just keep practicing. You don't have to just use it for renderings either. You can try it on a favorite picture of yours, like I did for this picture I took. Now how cool is that? Well, that's all I have for today, guys. It's very simple, but I wanted to take you step by step through this process, especially for those of you who are new to this. So leave a like if you found it helpful and subscribe for more videos in the future. Stay inspired, guys, and I'll see you next time.